What would you do if you could meet women during your everyday life with virtually no effort? Hey everyone, I'm Harris O'Malley from DrNerdLove.com, and today I want to talk about one of the most common questions I get. Where do you meet amazing, intelligent, ambitious women when you hate going to bars and clubs? That's a fair question. The bar and club scene has become synonymous with where to meet women, which is a little unfortunate. Now, personally, I got my start in the bar and club scene, and I had a lot of success meeting people, but I didn't really date any of them. And honestly, that's not much of a surprise. While bars are definitely social spaces where it's possible to approach and meet many people in the span of one night, most people don't meet their partners at bars or clubs. While the numbers vary depending on which survey or study you're looking at, only around 12 people met their significant other at a bar or club. Which makes sense. The bar and club scene can be great, and there are a lot of bars out there that don't necessarily fall into the Vegas nightclub or dive bar music venue or sleazy pickup joint vibe. But for a lot of people, they're just a no-go. They're too loud, they're too chaotic, they're too expensive, they're too smoky, they're too intimidating, they're just too much, period. They're great for meeting other people who also like the bar and club scene. And if that's not your jam, those are not the people that you're going to be the most compatible with. And while dating apps like Tinder, Match, OkCupid, and Bumble are on the rise, they're not at the top of the list yet either. Again, depending on the study, the number of people who've met their significant other through a dating app ranges somewhere between 8% and 15%. They're a great tool to have in your toolbox, don't get me wrong, but you don't want to rely on them exclusively. But there is a way to meet amazing women that doesn't require blowing your cash on overpriced drinks or shotgunning likes on Tinder. In fact, it's a method so powerful, no joke, it will bring women into your life almost without your having to do anything. It's building your lifestyle. In a very real way, we are what we do. Not our jobs, but how we spend our time and how we live our lives and who we spend it with. One of the first questions I ask people who want to know, how do I meet women, is what do you do? And the answer for a lot of them is not much. They get up, they go to work, they come home, repeat. They see the same people they've seen for years, they do the same thing they always do, and then they wonder why nothing's changed. This, frankly, is one of the reasons why they're not meeting anybody new. They're doing the same thing over and over again, expecting different results. If you want to meet women, you have to change things up. You have to go where the women are. They're not at your house, and they're not going to appear out of midair for you. But here's the thing. Working your lifestyle doesn't mean that you have to dress differently. Though let's be honest, it couldn't hurt. It doesn't mean you have to change your job, and it doesn't mean you have to spend lots of money. It means you have to change how you spend your time. You want to live your life in a way that naturally brings more people into it. Which brings me back to the question of what do you do? How are you spending your time right now, and how many new people are you meeting because of that? Odds are, not very many. So, how do we fix that, and more importantly, do so in a way that feels natural to you? And we start by focusing on what you already love. Finding ways to engage with the things that you love and the things you feel strongly about are a key part of how you meet new and amazing women. Part of this means building upon the things that you already enjoy or the causes that you feel strongly about. The more that you already enjoy something, the more comfortable you're going to be going out to participate in it. One of the reasons why bars and clubs don't necessarily make the best place to meet women for a lot of guys is because, quite frankly, they hate it. They're only going there because they feel like that's where they're supposed to go to meet people, and that dislike means that they're going to be burning through their energy reserves really quickly and gas out within a few minutes of being there and want to go home. On the other hand, when, say, you play a lot of Overwatch or PUBG, going to a gaming convention is going to feel like you're coming home. Signing up for a class or a lecture to study something that you're already interested in means that you're going to be much more excited and much more motivated to go. So the first step is to take the things that you love or feel strongly about and find a way to participate in them in a way that brings you in contact with other people. This may mean signing up for a class, or it may mean joining various meetup groups. Now, something to keep in mind is that you may not find a group that relates directly to something that you have an interest in. Some of this may be because of your interests, some of it may be because of the demographics of where you live. If you live in an area where there are not a lot of anime fans or not a lot of tabletop gamers, you may have a harder time finding a group to join. In cases like that, then what you want to do is to bankshot your interest a little bit. You may not find a lot of Pokemon Go players in your area, but you may find a group that likes to do day hikes or go urban exploring. You also want to check out some meetups, some classes, or some groups about interests that you may not necessarily have, but you're curious about and you've always wanted to try. While this won't have the immediate benefits of pursuing something related to your passions, it will expand your horizons and make you a more interesting person overall. And as I've said before, that makes you more attractive. Now, one thing you want to keep in mind are the type of events that you're looking into. For example, you may find a lot of happy hour type events for specific demographics. Young entrepreneurs, tech professionals, artists, so forth. These are great places to meet people, but they're designed as networking events, not meetups for singles. So it's great if you're looking to advance your career and make valuable contacts, not so much if you're trying to find a girlfriend. Instead, what you should do is look for activities, volunteer opportunities, and meetups that have you doing things with others. This may mean volunteering for a political campaign, or it may mean signing up for something that has you working in smaller teams, like signing up for a local amateur sports team, or joining a pinball league, or a skee-ball competition, or pub trivia, or scavenger hunts. The list is practically endless. The people who go to these events are going to be much more open to meeting people and socializing. It also has the benefit of breaking down the entire group into smaller, more manageable chunks, which can be a huge bonus if you're shy or introverted. Plus, working together is a great way to build chemistry and to find out who you do and don't click with very quickly. In fact, when he was casting Raiders of the Lost Ark, Steven Spielberg had Harrison Ford and Karen Allen go to a kitchen and prepare a meal together to check to see how much chemistry they had. Now, if you're a regular of my blog, or if you've checked out previous episodes, then you've heard me say that you want to prioritize approaching women in explicitly social spaces, places where people go specifically to meet and possibly date new people. Those generally don't include activities or meetup groups, which is why, unless it's an event specifically for singles, a meetup for young single musicians, for example, then you don't want to treat these events like singles bars. Nobody, even people who are actively looking for someone new to date or to hook up with, appreciate somebody coming into their meetup group and cruising it like a horny shark. This is why you don't go to these events looking for a date, at least not at first. You're connecting with them, making friends, not looking for dates right from the jump. This is important for a number of reasons. One is that, like I said last time, getting to know people is part of what makes us more attractive to them. The better people know you, the more they like you, and as any marketing executive can tell you, familiarity breeds affection. This, incidentally, means that you have to be an active participant. You can't just hang in the back and haunt the room like a ghost, or act like the kid who's hoping not to get called on by the teacher. It doesn't really do you any good to meet new and amazing people if you don't ever, you know, talk to them. The other thing is that you're not looking for dates. Not directly. While you will meet amazing women, many of whom you may well go out with, that's not your primary intention. What you're doing is expanding your social circle. See, the number one way that we meet people, even in the age of Tinder and Facebook, is through our friends. After all, our friends are who we spend the most time with, and they're the ones who are most likely to introduce us to other people. By making new friends, you're expanding your access to other people's social circles, which now lets you meet even more people. And this means it's much simpler and easier and more natural to get to know them. You're no longer trying to do a cold approach on a stranger at a bar. You're introducing yourself to the friend of a friend. Now, this doesn't mean that you should delete your Tinder account or never approach that cutie with the sketchbook. It's always worked out well for me. It's a good idea to diversify how you meet people instead of getting locked into one method. But building your social circle and meeting new people makes that process almost effortless. So, while you may not meet the love of your life at the skee-ball league or playing Geeks Who Drink Trivia, you may well meet the person who will introduce you to her. Hey, thanks for checking out my latest video. You've heard my thoughts, so I want to hear yours. What are you going to do to meet new people in 2018? And if you do have that special someone, how did you meet them? I want to hear all about it, so share your stories in the comments below. If you have a quick dating question or a topic that you'd like to hear me cover on here, hit me up. Either share it in the comments or send it to me at doc@drnerdlove.com with "for YouTube" in the subject header. And hey, if you want to know more about meeting women and forming those emotional connections, check out my books. I wrote them. You want to read them. Links to buy them are in the comments below. And if you do, be sure to leave a review on Amazon and Goodreads. It's a huge help. If you're digging the series, you know what to do. Hit that thumbs up button, be sure to share the video with all your friends. If you're really enjoying the series, if you're finding that it's helping and you're getting a lot out of it, then consider supporting the channel by becoming a patron at patreon.com/drnerdlove. Even $1 is a huge help. Meanwhile, follow me on Twitter @drnerdlove and join the Facebook page @facebook.com/drnerdlove. And as always, smash that logo to subscribe. Check out my other videos, and I will be back with you next time with more about love, sex, and dating. Later.